There's the island we just left. San Miguel. Couldn't stay because of the possibility of bad northeast winds tonight. Not bad, but just any northeast winds in that anchorage would be bad. Like, honestly, 5 knots, because the fetch is all the way across here and the swells would come in. And so right now we're trying to go to Santa Barbara, which is 36 miles. Is that right?
Yeah.
36 miles away. We had to leave before dark, otherwise I would have just left like at midnight or something. But the rocks in that harbor, as you left, we probably could have done it. We could have followed our track. It wouldn't have been a big deal, but I just get nervous leaving a place like that with, oh, look at all these pelicans. Check this out. They are the most prehistoric birds. They're so cool. Look at them go. I like them. They've been flying back and forth from the island to here. Anyway, yeah, so we left, and now we're trying to go as slow as we can so that we arrive in daylight. So we're basically trying to do 2 knots.
two and a half will get us there between 8 and 9 o'clock in the morning.
So normally we're trying to go a little faster, now we're trying to go slow. So we have no motor on right now. The only electronic besides lights and whatnot is the autopilot. And yeah, no, the wind vane would not work in this. There is no wind. But Otto, he's determined. So yeah, this is our beautiful situation tonight. And it is beautiful. I mean, we're just sitting out here in the cockpit, Norman and I, chatting, getting ready for another night offshore. What did we have for dinner?
We had tacos again. So good.
They are good. This time I used my Melinda's ghost pepper hot sauce. Mmm, it's hot. I like it. I would have preferred to have spent the night in that nice anchorage, though. There they go again. Look at them all. I wonder if they could show up on this. So many of them. I mean, it's just like they all are migrating over to the island in the evening like this. I wonder why. It is a beautiful, beautiful evening.
Look at that. Gentle swells.
Look at that color. We got both sails up, and they actually are. We are actually sailing. Here comes a bunch of different birds. But they're heading to the island too. They fly across this channel, I guess, to the islands, to the Channel Islands.
They got an Airbnb. Air birds and bugs.
Air birds and bugs. Norman. Wow. That's a big swell too. See, now we're on the bottom. And yeah, it's so hard to explain to somebody that can't see it. There you go. You can kind of see the back end of it as it left us. Well, I'll include this stuff into the video so you know what it, you know, all of the different parts of being out here on the boat. And we're going to a marina. Ugh. We were talking about that too, you know. It just seems like
we're just older and we're playing it safer.
I'd do the same thing when I was young, because there's no place to go. I mean, you have to take your boat to the safe harbor, and we got a blow coming. And if there was an anchorage on any of these three islands that would be safe with the blow that's coming, I would be there. But there aren't on the other side. They're not. Well, not that I've seen anyway, and I haven't read about any, so. Any of you that are from around here, hey, how about our friend Jeff May? You tell us if you knew of any. Comment in the comments, Jeff. let us know.
All right, Topher back there filling the generator with some gasoline.
Hi guys.
Beautiful.
So, this is my little spot. I have a little cushion I put on the generator and I sit here. I'm gonna trade you, I'm gonna give you this back and trade and take your phone. I'll promise not to drop it. There you go. I just want y'all to see what it's like sitting back here on this spot. It's so cool. Say hi, Norman. Hi, say hi to the camera, Norman.
Hi, Norman.
Look at that sunset. Oh my gosh, it's beautiful.
Santa Barbara. This is a beautiful place. I've never been here before. And it is really, really beautiful. And it finally feels like California. Now, it feels nice and warm. Bunch of seals sleeping on the you can see them. A bunch of them. Look at the pelicans. And there was a whale right out here. Pretty crazy. Yeah, there's an anchorage over here. Looks like it's mooring balls. Not sure what the deal is with that. We're coming in right now. Normally we would not have cut the corner on this green buoy. I know it's red right returning. However, we watched a ton of boats coming out of here that were bigger than us. So we knew it was all right. My friend Norm is driving the boat again. beautiful place. Pretty cool place, man. It smells really, really good. Like breakfast. I think it's this restaurant right here. Or maybe more than one restaurant right here. Beautiful little town area here by the marina. I bet it's expensive. We're kind of thinking it probably is. It is a cool marina. I think it's one of the coolest I've been to from the entrance. There's Norm doing his thing. We kind of know what we're doing here. We read up on it, so hopefully we know. Look at all these pelicans. I don't know if you can see them. Look at all those pelicans, Norm. That's where all the ones we saw last night were coming from, flying over to the island. We saw them, just like tons of them, flying over to the island last night when we left. All right. This is Santa Barbara. There she is, and you can see the area right there was the part that was covered in that oil, and I got most of it off with the magic eraser. There's still some back here that I'm gonna have to get in the water to clean, but most of it's off. It's a pretty little marina here. Actually, kind of like it. Some of you might be familiar with it. Here's some more up in the bow that I couldn't get to yet. We got most of this side clean because it's on the dock, but right here it's a little bit far for us to reach. So there she is, my pretty little boat. She really has been quite amazing. I'm very impressed with her so far. And I think it was my buddy Ivan the Terrible, mentioned our canvas. This canvas really is cool. So we've got full covers for all of the teak handrails on each side. And then the Dodger has these covers that snap on around the Dodger to keep it shady inside. Then we've got our splash guards, and then this little connector, which works when the boat is underway as well. We just haven't used it yet underway, but when we get into the hot sun in the South Pacific, we will be using it. And this little flap is nice. It covers up Norman's hatch, so when he's in there, if it's raining, he doesn't get all soaking wet. And then I'm going to show you something else that we did. That Norman did. I shouldn't say we. Norman did this. Put this little lashing here for a handle. My intention was for this to be that, and I wanted it to go where it rubs back and forth right here. See, I'm gonna have to clean that. I'll use a magic eraser to clean that off. But I do like this stuff. But he made this nice little handle, and then on either side of that, and then he lashed
remember, we have Gorilla tape underneath there, and it's held down with, you know, it's screwed in and everything, the little connector for our wind vane and for our autopilot, which I made that, by the way, out of a piece of flat stainless, bent it over at home, and then Norman cut out that little piece of teak right there and attached it, and then we screwed all that down with 5200 underneath. And then it's got Gorilla tape, and then we lashed it. Well, we didn't lash it. Norman lashed it. He did a really good job. And that thing ain't going anywhere now. So I like it too. I like the looks of it. I know some of you probably wouldn't, but this is my boat. I get to do what I want. Hey, Norman. This is what I see often. I look up here. I see, here, do your peeky. The peeky thing you do. That's what he does. He peeks out. There, Norman.
What I do.
Yeah. Hey, good job on that. It looks really great.
It does look good. I like it too.
What's your job you have for today?
Well, we're going to try to lash those little
pinrail
boards to the side stays. And
so what's wrong with the way they are right now?
They kind of move a little bit. The little boards is kind of, it would, we kind of lashed above and below them, but they still kind of want to move a little bit.
So how are you going to fix that?
I'm going to use some of that seizing rope stuff and kind of do a little X, kind of zigzag back and forth to kind of hold it there, and then hopefully it'll keep it more solid.
The same twine.
Same twine, that's it.
Yeah, so he'll be done with that today. I'll put that in this video, the finished product of it, and you can see what that looks like. All right, so this is what Norm did. He lashed those. There wasn't enough room on the ends here to go in an X back and forth. There wasn't enough of the sticking out on either side, which is good because you don't want the jib sheet to snag on it, you know, which it kind of does up here. It snags on that sometimes. So I might cut that off at some point a little bit so that we don't have that problem. But now, see, now this doesn't move up and down at all. Works pretty good. So she's lashed on good now. And he changed our, we have a bunch of these UV protected black pull ties. And he changed out the white ones that we had on there for those. So, all right, he did both sides. So this side and that side's done. Okay, thanks for coming this week. Next week, I think you will see a tour of the marina area here in Santa Barbara, and there's a really cool maritime museum that Norman and I are gonna go and make fun of. And so we will, no, I'm just kidding, we're not gonna make fun of. Well, there may be some making fun, generally speaking.
It's so not us.
It's, you know, we can't help ourselves. So yeah, we're gonna do that, and that'll be next week. And then the week after that, you'll have that boat tour of our new friends on YouTube channel Ramble On and their amazing Tiana 37 sailboat. You'll like it. Together.